Hi guys, it's Callum here from Total Endurance. So just a quick video to chat you through the Hoka Challenger. So this actually just came out a couple of weeks, so a relatively kind of new shoe to us. So yeah, Challenger, it's a very, I would say, unique shoe. It's an all-out hybrid shoe, which a lot of brands don't really do. So when you say hybrid, it kind of means that it's both suitable for a little bit of road running, a little bit of trail running. Maybe your local route requires you to run both kind of road and trail. So what's allowing you to be able to work with both terrains? One is the cushioning of it. So again, Hoka's EVA compressed cushioning. It feels very similar to Clifton 9 in terms of the cushioning with it, but actually what they've done is they've added a much more durable kind of rubber outsole. So these are 4mm kind of durabrasion lugs on them, so not the most aggressive lugs out on the market, but the reason behind that is you need to be able to run on the road. So we had kind of major big kind of rubber outsole onto big lugs. You'd find they would just wear away on the road and would feel not great to run in. So what they've also then done with that is put those rubber lugs where you need them most. So bang on the forefoot, so running downhill, maybe landing on your forefoot first, that means it's going to give you that grip. And then again, on this kind of outer edge as well. So a lot of people tend to land on this outer border, so it just kind of reinforces it a little bit. So the kind of typical terrain as well, if you're maybe doing railway line where sometimes it's a little bit of road, sometimes it's trail, Kirkhill Forest, that type of thing, it's going to work really, really well on it. Another reason, people might just use an all-out trail shoe, but actually if you find most trail shoes are just too solid, a lot of them are very minimal for doing kind of technical mountain runs. If you're one of those people who just doesn't like trail shoes because they're too firm, Challenger is going to feel really good for you just because it has got that typical cushioning that you might expect in a normal kind of road shoe. So yeah, that's really cool. Upper, again, still very nice. It's a little bit more, it's essentially made from a recycled material. It's a little bit more robust, so slightly more reinforced like you would expect with a trail shoe. So for me, road shoe upper is always a bit more comfortable, but you need it to be a little bit more robust. So if you're happy to smack your feet off twigs and branches and stuff, you're just going to get that kind of mileage out of it. In terms of sizing, pretty standard, I would say, for a Hoka. I need to go up half a size, so 8.5 and on. I have to do a 9 in a Hoka, and I need to do a 9 in this version. For me, just toe box wise, it just comes in a little bit narrow. It does come in a wide version as well, so that's probably worth considering. So yeah, really good option, I would say, from Hoka, especially for those girls and guys who love softer trail shoes, and maybe you're doing a little bit of mixed terrain, so both tarmac and trail. So yeah, that's the new Hoka Challenger 7.